Our today's topic is Muslim scientists and their contribution. Muslim scientists gave a lot of knowledge to the science of biology, or we can say that they are the backbone of our modern ideas. Their views are highly appreciated and taken as authority. Some of the famous Muslim scientists are following. First scientist name is Jaber bin Hayyan. He was born in Iran and practiced in Iraq. He worked in experimental chemistry and performed his experiments, but he wrote number of books on plants and animals. One famous book is Al-Nabatat. As its name shows, it is about plants, and Al-Hayawan is about animals. He was said to be an astronomer, pharmacist, physician, philosopher, engineer of that area, because up to some limit he worked in all these fields. Next scientist is Abdul Malik Asmai. He was born in Basra. He was regarded as a specialist in animal sciences. He studied about the body structure of different animals and wrote many books on different animals. His famous books are following: Al-Abil, which is about the camels; Al-Khail is about horses; Asha about sheep; and fourth, Al-Wahush, is about wild animals. He also studies the anatomy of human body. Anatomy means internal structure of human being. And he wrote his observation in a book, Khalaqul Insan. In this book, he described different parts of the human body and their function. Next scientist is Bu Ali Sina. This scientist done great work in medicine. His valuable work was in the area of disease of eye. He described about 130 diseases of the eye in his book. He wrote a book, Al-Qanun Fil Tib, which was so famous that it was translated into many European languages, and people get benefit from this book. Next scientist is Abu Usman Umar Al-Jahiz. He observed the different animals and their behavior. He wrote a book on his own observation. The book name was Al-Hayawan. In this book, he observed the seasonal migration of fish in river Tigris. Some animals migrate from the area which is not suitable for them, especially the temperature and climate. So animals migrate from that region. Some migration of fish in the river Tigris was observed by Umar Usman Al-Jahiz, as well as he also noted the life system of an ant, how the ant they live, because ants, they are a social animal. They always live in groups. Scientist is Al-Farabi. Al-Farabi described the plants and animals in his book. His two books are famous, Kitabul Nabatat and Kitabul Hayawanat. As the name shows, Kitabul Nabatat is about the plants and Kitabul Hayawanat is about the animals. Abdul Qasim Al-Zahrawi is also a famous scientist because he performed an experiment in surgery. The presence of stone in urinary bladder is dangerous for the life of human being. It was the first surgeon which removed the stone from the urinary bladder. So this scientist was famous for its contribution in the history of medical science. Ibn al-Haytham is a very famous scientist because it has worked in the vision of the eye. He described the vision, the phenomena and focusing of light in the eye, how the eye functions and their different parts. This scientist was famous to describe the structure of human eye. First time he discovered that the layer of eye, which is named as retina, is important for the vision. So we can say that it was the first person to describe the retina as a seat of vision. Ali bin Isa. At that time, he was known as the eye specialist because he worked on